Okay, we are going to solve some, so to say, higher order level questions. Okay, so here is a question. Displacement x is related with a velocity like this. V is equal to under root of 2x plus 9. Okay, you need to find out its acceleration and initial velocity. What is the initial velocity? Initial velocity, and you need to find what is the acceleration. And it is moving in a straight line. The object is going in a straight line. No, u is going to be equal to 0. Okay, I'll solve it now. Are you trying to integrate or differentiate? Trying to do that? You can differentiate also and get the answer. dv by dt is acceleration. See, we can't spend a lot of time in a single question. You understand that. I'm just introducing question to you. This is not a test where I'll wait till, right? I'll wait for a couple of minutes. If you're not getting it, then I'll solve it. You'll understand what is the concept. Okay? So here, square both sides, we get v square equal to 2x plus 3 square. So compare it with v square equal to u square plus 2ax. It's a constant acceleration. So v square is u square and a is 1. Okay? Or if you really like to differentiate, dv by dt is acceleration, which is derivative of this. When you differentiate it, dx by dt will also come, which is v. Okay, when you differentiate, we get 1 divided by 2 under root 2x plus 9 into 2 into dx by dt. dx by dt is v, which is under root of 2x plus 9. So this and that get cancelled, we get it as 1. Or you can identify that this is a constant acceleration motion. So v square equal to u square by 2x. You can compare it and get the answer. Understood? Okay, next one. V is equal to mod of t minus 2 meter per second. This is how velocity is changing. Have you seen mod before? I got mod. You need to find, this is moving a straight line, okay? You need to find the amount of distance in 4 seconds. Distance or displacement. Not actually displacement. Distance. In fact, both are same. Okay, so how you have done this?
T is 4.
Put t equal to 4. You get velocity as 2.
Yeah.
Then you multiply 2 with 4.
Yeah.
Velocity is not constant.
Yes.
If it is constant, then velocity into time is distance.
See, acceleration is 1 and then...
Like that you can find. And using graph, the best way is to use graph. The area of VT curve is displacement. Okay? So this is your time and this is velocity. So this is, let's say, 2. So you will see that this kind of graph will be there.
Yeah.
Yes.
The area of this graph is your displacement. We have learned this, right? Or if you like to integrate, you can integrate also. Integral v dt. Integrate. There you go. V is what? Dx by dt. This is equal to mod of t minus 2. Okay, so dx is t minus 2 dt integrate. Now mod t minus 2 You can split it into two parts, 0 to 2. When t goes from 0 to 2, mod of t minus 2 is how much? Between 0 to 2. Minus of t minus 2. Mod. Are you mod of x is minus x if x is less than 0. So when t is less than 2, t minus 2 is negative. So minus of that. Okay? So between 0 to minus 0 to 2, it is minus of t minus 2 dt, and plus 2 to 4, it will be t minus 2 dt. When you integrate, you'll get the answer. Got it? Okay? Next question. Okay? Next one. Alright, focus here. Here is the second question. Two particles instantaneously at point A and B, 4.5 meter apart. A and B, 4.5 meter apart. Start drawing the diagram itself. Point A, and this is point B. Okay? They are moving with constant velocity, the former towards B at 1.5 meter per second, A is going towards B 1.5 meter per second. And the latter perpendicular to AB at 1.125 meter per second. So a simple velocity for me. Okay. We'll just create equation, we'll not solve it completely. Let's say ye 2 meter per second hai. Okay, this is 10 meters. Now get a nice value. This one is 4 meter per second. Not 4 actually. Let's take it. 1 meter per second. Okay? You need to find out time when they are nearest to each other. Direction of motion is not changing. So A will always go down, B will always go horizontal. Time when they are nearest each other.
Five seconds.
No. B is also moving. If B is fixed, then.
But it's the time of moving.
You are guessing the answer. You have not solved it. You are guessing the answer. There's a difference. Even though that may be a correct answer, it will not help you to solve the other question. You solved it? How? The line joining between any two points will be straight line only. Always a linear straight line. Perpendicular? There is no point of having perpendicular. Only one line is there. Line joining A and B. This is standard type of question. Acha, let me give you a hint. Find out the distance between them after time t. ये मैच पढ़ा था ना y is equal to x2 minus x1 whole square y2 minus क्यों पढ़ा था मैच में to apply in physics क्या coordinate geometry is you learn mathematics to understand physics only this is a distance formula use a distance formula here Okay, here it is. Let's say this is y-axis, this is x-axis. After time t, third term, after time t, the y-coordinate of A will be what? 10 minus 2t. After time t, the x-coordinate of B is t, 1 into t. Yes or no? And x-coordinate of A is 0. And y coordinate of B is 0. The distance between them after time t, distance will be root over x2 minus x1 whole square, which is t square, plus y2 minus y1 whole square, which is 10 minus 2t whole square. So this is the distance you have got as a function of time. You need to minimize this. You know how to minimize a function? Minimum of this function you need to find out. Minimum. Have you learned derivative, minimum, maximum? Okay, so fx, if it is a continuous function, will be minimum or maximum when derivative of fx with respect to any variable becomes 0. Okay, understood? Why it is like that? Stop talking. Suppose this is a function fx with respect to x. Okay, now you can see that this is x and this is fx. Dfx by dx is nothing but slope of this graph. This is the minimum. So slope is 0 over here. And over there also slope is 0. Okay, so whenever the function is maximum or minimum, derivative of that function is 0. You can use it as a thumb rule. We'll be discussing it in greater detail when in mathematics, Akhil sir will teach you how to maximize or minimize. So you can take derivative of t with respect to time and equate that to 0. You will get the value of t, time, where the distance is minimum. Understood? Okay.